All right, we're going to talk in this video about how intellectual property, IP as they call it, is fake and everyone knows it. Okay, that's what we're going to talk about. Now, first off, got to clear some things up because a lot of people don't know what intellectual property actually is. A lot of people got it twisted, okay, frankly, because I'll talk about, in a video, I'll say something like, oh yeah, IP is obviously stupid and everyone knows it, and then people will get confused as what that actually is because I think there's a lot of misinformation about that. Two things. First off, intellectual property is not the same thing as branding or fraud. For example, if I want to start a power tool company, let's say I make a really junky impact driver, a drill or something like that. An impact driver is like a drill. It's different. It's not important. So let's say I make a really junky one of those, and then I put, because I actually want to sell it, even though it's a bad product, so I put the logo from another company on it. So I'll put like a DeWalt logo on it, okay? That is not intellectual property violation. That is not what that is. Okay, that's fraud. All right. If I sell something pretending that it's something else that it isn't, especially if I am putting the idea in the consumer's head that oh, this is actually made by someone else who actually has a good reputation, that's fraud. That's not the same thing as an intellectual property violation. So a lot of people will get confused. They'll say, oh, you don't believe in IP? That means that someone could just take your stuff and pretend to be you. No, that's not, absolutely not what that means. That means something different, okay? You can say something like intellectual property is stupid, but still be like, let's say I write a software project and someone else takes it and says, oh, well, I wrote this, okay? That's not the same. Now, I think that people should be able to distribute software, take and change and, you know, software and stuff like that. But obviously, it is fraud to put that on your CV as if you do that. That is a different thing. To say that is bad is not the same thing as saying intellectual property is bad. Okay, so that's misunderstanding number one. Number two is saying something like, oh, software should be free or intellectual property is fake does not mean you don't believe in trade secrets, for example. So there's I write a bunch of software on my computer. There are some scripts and stuff that I write on my servers. Those are not publicly available, okay? And believing that intellectual property specifically in software is fake does not mean that you have to make everything public. It doesn't mean you have to share everything. It doesn't mean you can't have secrets in your life. That is all. If I say I don't believe in intellectual property, that's not the same thing, okay, as this, okay? So let's talk about what intellectual property actually is in context, okay? Now, firstly, culturally speaking, intellectual property is really just an artifact of Anglo-American jurisprudence, okay? You go to other countries, you go to other cultures, the concept does not exist. Chinese people, intellectual property, what? Lol. A lot of people in Eastern Europe, frankly, everywhere in the world, except for America and places that America has conquered culturally in one way or another, they have no concept of intellectual property. It is a very specific meme that originated, and it's a forced meme, frankly. So, let's talk about property in general, okay? Property in general, the reason we have property is a social convention to distribute, or to decide who gets to use what and who has priorities, right? So, in effect, you know, if you have a society where everyone is extremely poor, not just poor, but let's say, you don't need objects you're a hunter and gatherer. You don't really need you don't need to have houses and land and like cooking equipment or anything too fancy. There's really no need for the convention of property. So although it arises sometimes in very primitive societies, it's at a very low level. Okay. Whereas at a society of even a basic level of complexity, the concept of property emerges very quickly, especially if you're sedentary, right? Because you have a scarce amount of goods. You know, you might have, let's say you don't have as many cars as people, but even in that case, let's say you have more cars than people. One problem is, if people do not take care of the thing, if everything is public property, or at least no one's property, there's a big issue of who's actually going to take care of it. I mean, there's the idea, if you own land, for example, That's really like a double-edged sword. You can use that land to make money, but you also have to take care of it. That's a big liability, okay? You own a rental house? Oof. Ever owned a rental house? That's a pain, okay? You lose money in very unexpected ways, okay? So there's a dual responsibility with property, okay? Now, intellectual property. What is the difference between intellectual property and property property? Okay. Intellectual property is not property. That's the difference. The difference is, if I take your axe or something like that, you no longer have an axe. If I copy your song, you still have that song. Okay? There's nothing has changed. I did not deprive, like, intellectual property, so-called, is not scarce. It does not have scarcity. There's no such thing. It doesn't happen. Okay? No matter how many times I copy a song, you still have it. You have not been deprived of that. In fact, it seems a little weird to arbitrarily say, oh, well, I mean, if you thought about it in the context of physical goods, it would be obviously absurd. If we could just copy axes or copy houses or copy land, that would be great. We could just give everyone everything and there wouldn't actually be a problem, okay? Because there would be no scarcity, okay? We actually can do that in digital goods. We can do that in ideas, except unless we have intellectual property, okay? We have to, and it's actually a little absurd because I think even people who do this intellectual property stuff, I know a lot of them think they're getting a quick buck, but in reality, I mean, I've seen people who have 1,000 viewers on YouTube who like paywall half of their videos, okay? They're trying to, protect the distribution of it and stuff like that, which has always struck me as like, frankly, absurd because in a lot of for most purposes, it's nice to live in an environment where you can easily distribute intellectual property. It's actually good for the people who make that kind of stuff. Of course, there are ways you can exploit intellectual property law to sue people for royalties and, like, you know, become a millionaire due to, like, the kind of IP structure here. But it is honestly, the reason I release everything, obviously, is free software, is because I think it's a better thing for me long-term if I do that. Okay, I could be making lots of money if I sold, you want to install Mutt Wizard? You want to install my email wizard, which is just like a script? I could make that a binary. I could just make it, I could sell that for $100 a pop. And for a lot of people, I actually would buy it. I mean, it's very nice. I mean, you could do cool stuff with that. Set up your own email server. But, that's the kind of thing where it's just sort of, another thing to think about, if you're thinking about like cultural things, let's say like music. All right. So here's a fun fact. Even in the United States, if you look back at the early 20th century, intellectual property was never actually applied to music. It was absurd. Like the idea, nowadays we have these multi-billion-dollar record companies that are getting rich off these songs and stuff like that. But back in the past, that wasn't the case. Okay. People just, guess what? People still wrote songs. Okay. And back in the day, you know, how a lot of people got famous as singers is actually taking songs that other people had written and just recording them all, singing them all, and making albums out of that, okay? Sell their albums. Which, of course, you can still sell albums. You can still, you know, physically sell objects. You know, there's nothing wrong. You know, saying you don't believe in IP is not the same thing as that, okay? But, yeah. In fact, technically, IP is not necessarily the same thing as copyright either. Copyright is sometimes thought of as a category of IP. You could believe in a copyright. Like a copyright would be, let's say I'm the first one to make this particular invention. Well, for the government says for the first 10 years, you can, no one else can copy that. Only you can make copies of it. Okay. That's technically a little different than intellectual property, but I guess you could say it's a category of that. But you could believe in narrow copyrights and still not believe in intellectual property as a thing. Okay. But I don't believe in either. I think they're the same stupidity. What was I going to say? So, yeah, a lot of people have this weird idea. And, frankly, this is depressing to me. Because intellectual property, I think, brings mediocrity to a lot of art. Because what happens is, you know, people who are internally motivated to write or to make music or to, even, frankly, write software in a sense, they're going to be doing it whether they're getting millions of dollars for it or not, okay? Like, when people are actually passionate artists, that's just something they do. If they're actually passionate writers, that's just what they're going to do. The idea that we need some targeted economic incentive for people to do something is absurd. It's just totally ahistoric. Like, if we needed intellectual property for anything, and I mean, we intellectual property has not existed for all of human history. There have even been copyrights at periods, but intellectual property as the idea, as an idea does not exist, and you don't need it. Like, even in the case, like, if I become a famous sculptor, I make a great sculpture, It is still, if someone copies my sculpture and tries to sell it as mine, okay, that's still fraud. That's not the same thing as intellectual property. It's a different thing. Now, if they're just selling it openly as a replica, oh, this is a replica of this famous sculpture that he made, okay, that would be different. But the idea, like, a lot of people just think that not believing in intellectual property means all this weird stuff that it doesn't, or it means, I don't know, just people are, or it means you have to share, or if you believe in free software, that means you have to give everyone the passwords to your computer so they can see what's going on. It's just like, I don't know. I've had people had, oh, you believe in privacy, but you're not telling everyone what you're doing on a computer? It's just so stupid. Yeah, that's about it. So I just find it, intellectual property, I just find it very frustrating. And it's hard to describe the world we would live in if we didn't have to deal with this kind of stuff. If we could just, if you could just look at a program you like and just take a snippet of code from it, or a video game or something like that, and we would have a whole environment of people, especially in software, of people sort of creatively, people who are genuinely inspired using this kind of stuff creative. And it actually, this is, I want to do maybe another video on this. Maybe I'll just turn this off when I'm done with this video and start the other video I was going to record. But I want to talk about how, I know this sounds not characteristic of me, but gaming on Linux and how much better it would be if there were no intellectual property. Okay? That I know that sounds like an absurd thing. But anyway, that's my view on it. One last point, though. I'm not a moralist. I'm not like, oh, dude, if you use intellectual property, that's, wow, I can't believe that's terrible. No, I don't think that at all. I think that people should exploit the legal system that they live in. You know, and if that means you making a bunch of proprietary programs or something and taking advantage of those laws, like, I'm not really gonna think you're a bad person for that at all. Now, I believe that it is better, even in my own interest, to release things as free software. And that's why, I mean, I think that is just better long-term, frankly. That's just how I see things. Like, I feel weird about artificially constraining how things can get around. And I think it would be weird if I did that for my YouTube channel. Like, I look at other people online. Like, there are some other channels who will do this stuff where, like, they put some videos on YouTube, and then they put a bunch of other videos behind a paywall or something like that. Like, oh, you gotta get my better tutorials, my Luke Smith Plus. You gotta pay $60 a month or something stupid. I just find that a little like self-undermining. Maybe you're making a buck. I'm just maybe not about that. Even if I like wrote a book or something like that. Like, I want people to take those ideas. Like, I'm not there to make money off of it. I want people to be able to copy and change that around. And, you know, I will sell physical copies of it, but that is not the same thing as, it's not the same thing as intellectual property. It's just not the same thing. So, just think really hard about that, or don't.